This is a CV-VS Zojirushi water boiler. And lately it's been taking longer and longer and longer to stop boiling. And actually last time it boiled, it just kept going forever until I eventually unplugged it. So I had a look inside earlier. This particular unit is it's made in 2013, so about 6 years old. Actually more like seven. And it's been doing pretty well so far. Obviously we should unplug the power. So now we need to get into this box. There's actually four plastic tabs. We just need to pop those open. Now, last time I was in here, I checked the relay. What I did was I got a multimeter, set it to ohms. And then we can clamp it onto the terminals of the relay. And this reads high right now, which is good. Previously it read zero. What can happen with this relay is that the contact gets stuck and it's intermittent. And if you jostle the unit, if you pull the terminals or anything like that, it may snap the relay back open and then you'll get a good reading. But this is one of the only mechanical parts in the unit. So if your unit continues to boil forever, it's a pretty good idea or a pretty good bet that it's this relay. So now we're gonna get this board out and then swap out the relay. One thing I will say about this Japanese boiler is that it's really well made. These screws are really tight. Everything is very mechanically sound. It was a little more difficult than I wanted to pop this board out. So I've been having trouble getting this thing to come loose. I think one of the problems is that these terminals act as heat sinks, and they pull a lot of the heat away from the iron, which makes it difficult to keep the pins hot enough to keep the solder melted. So I found I have a little bit of solder wick, and I'm going to try that now. So I've got here an alcohol pad. Basically, it's one of my wife's facial pads, don't tell her. Soaked with rubbing alcohol. And we can use that to get all this solder paste gunk off the board. It's not strictly necessary, but I think it's workmanlike. And also this entire board could be under high heat and it might cause fumes or a puff of smoke or something like that if we don't clean it up. So one thing I did notice is I have a solder bridge here now. It doesn't actually matter because these two terminals are both belong to the same pad electrically, but in general it's a good idea to be on the lookout for those when you're doing rework on a board. There's a tiny tab that you have to get the board under at the back side here where my finger's pointing.